Hey, what's going on, everybody? Jake here with Venture Visuals, and on this channel, we discuss and break down popular video editing tricks, tips, and techniques. And today, I am stoked because we are going to be breaking down three really cool background slide transitions that you can create in Adobe Premiere Pro and Adobe After Effects. I wanted to do this video to give you guys kind of the basic foundational understanding of how you can create these really dope transitions. If you're excited about creating your own background slide transitions, definitely hit the like button down below and let's get into it. Before we begin creating these slide transitions, let's go ahead and take a look at this music video just to catch a vibe.
Back in this bitch we lit. Yeah, what's out the city to fold? First one, I'm back on my shit. Yeah. All of you niggas be hating on the niggas, suck on the dick. Yeah, niggas be mad, sad. Yo, bitch, she all on my dick.
So we have him kind of outside walking on the stairs, and then we have him inside this overhang. I'm gonna listen for the drums and see if we can find a nice drum hit where the background slide transition will start.
Back in this bitch, back in this.
So maybe right at the end of that line right there where it kind of gets quiet, we can start the background slide transition. So the first thing you wanna do is duplicate this first clip by holding option and dragging it up. And then we're just gonna drag this clip out above our second clip right here. And then we're gonna hit C to cut the excess off the first part of that clip. When you're doing these types of background slide transitions, you should think of your video layers like a hamburger or a sandwich, right? So we're putting all these ingredients on in between two buns, and then with these background slides, we can remove things from that sandwich to reveal other ingredients. So I know it's a little goofy, but that's what I do. So what we're gonna do with this clip is we're gonna right click on it, we're gonna hit nest, and hit okay. And then what we're gonna do is import it into After Effects by hitting replace with After Effects composition. Now that we're in After Effects, we're going to duplicate our layer by hitting Command D, and we're going to rename this one Roto. And then this one on the bottom, we'll call this one background so we can easily separate the two. So what I'm gonna do with this top layer, this Roto layer, is come up here to my Rotobrush tool. I'm gonna double click on this video, and I'm gonna start tracing around his outline. This is gonna give us a nice cutout. Whenever you're done tracing your rotoscope outline, you're going to see this kind of purpley pink line around whatever it is that you're tracing, and then all you're gonna do is hit 2 on your keyboard to move to the next frame, and you can see that After Effects does a great job of automatically tracing whatever it is that you're trying to cut out from the backgrounds. What I can do is hop back into my composition layer here, and you won't notice any difference right away, okay? So what we can do is actually hide this background layer, make sure that you toggle your transparency grid on so it's a transparent background, and then we can turn our background layer back on. Now all we're gonna do is select our background layer and hit P on our keyboard to pull up our position keyframes, hit this little stopwatch icon here, and then we're gonna come all the way close to the end, click on this background, hold shift, and drag it down out of the frame. So we get another keyframe value here at the end, and then I can just drag that all the way to the last frame like so. And now you can see our background is sliding out of the frame. Now, if you wanna make this look a little bit more natural with the motion, what we can do here is toggle our switches and modes down at the bottom, make sure that we have this little three circle icon here for motion blur. We can actually check the motion blur on. That's going to blur the background as it slides out of the frame. Now, what I'm going to do is keyframe the position of our rotoscope layer. So I'm just gonna click on our rotoscope layer and I'm going to hit P to pull up my position value. I'm going to make a position value there at the beginning. Towards the end, we're going to have him slide maybe to the left, or you could go up or down, it doesn't matter. But for this, we're going to go to the left and drag him out like that. We've already got motion blur turned on here, so now you can see we have both of these moving out of the way. So for this, I think we'll keyframe him. We'll start his movement a little bit after the background slide starts, so the background actually starts to slide out before he begins to move out of the frame. If you want to make this look a little bit better, what you can do is right click on your first keyframes and you're going to come down to keyframe assistant and hit easy ease out. Open up the graph editor using this icon. You're just going to tweak these handlebars out. So basically with this curve, we're telling Premiere Pro that we want it to start a little bit slower and then speed up as he exits the frame right there. So using the graph editor is a really nice way to get an even smoother look. All I'm gonna do is hit Command S, save it back into Premiere Pro. And now we're back in Premiere Pro, we can see that we have our linked sequence from After Effects working above our timeline. And because we have our next clip sitting underneath and our transparency turned on, this background slide is going to reveal the next clip.
Back in this bitch, we lit.
For this next background slide transition, we're going to be using a matte transition from my matte transitions pack. And if you don't have the pack, you can actually try it out for free on my website. I want this transition to start right as soon as this base is hitting right here. So what we're going to do is actually cut this first clip, drag it up to video layer 2, drag our next clip out underneath. And now I've got my matte transition pack opened here. They're all MP4 files and you can just view them by hitting spacebar on any of them. I actually really like this first one we clicked on in from left. This will look really clean. So let's drag this into our timeline here and let's extend our first clip out to match the length of this transition. Come over here to my effects. I'm gonna type in track matte key, throw that onto our middle layer. We're gonna change our composite using to matte luma, and then we're going to change the matte to whatever video layer our matte transition is on. So that would be video layer 3. And now we can see we have a transition happening here. So let's just check out what this matte transition looks like without doing any type of rotoscope. I really like it. I think it needs to be a little bit quicker. So what we can do with our matte transition selected, we can hit Command R. We can speed this up. Let's go to like 150%. And let's take our bottom clip in there. That's way better. It hits more on time with the beat. Cut our bottom layer, this clip that we're revealing, and we're gonna hold Option and drag it up to this very top layer. Right click on it, hit Nest, hit OK, right click on it again, and hit Replace with After Effects Composition. So with this layer selected and my Rotobrush tool turned on, I'm gonna click on this video preview, and I'm just gonna trace around his outline. Now when I go back to my composition, we should see him totally isolated from the rest of the clip. So what I'm gonna do with this first layer is just hit P again, and I'm gonna create a keyframe on position. This time I'm gonna drag this first keyframe here to the very end. We want him to end up in the position he's going to be in during the beginning of the next clip. But at this very beginning frame, what we can do is actually move him out of the frame so he slides in like this. And now I'm going to turn motion blur on. Since we're sliding into the frame, what I'm gonna do is right click on this second keyframe. So I'm gonna come down to keyframe assistant and hit easy ease in, open up my graph editor and tweak the handlebars just a little bit to give it more of a distinct slide in. Now when we preview this in After Effects, we can see the effect that we're getting on a transparent background. Command D on this layer again. We're gonna open up the keyframe values on this second rotoscope layer, and we're just gonna change this first value. So let's just drag this other rotoscope copy somewhere else. Let's drag him like up this way maybe so he kind of comes in from the right. So now when I scroll through, we have two clones that are going to meet up in the center where the next clip is going to start, and it's gonna give us a more unique look. So what we're gonna do is just hit Command S. Let's hop back into Premiere Pro. One of the things I like to do with rotoscopes is add a little bit of an echo effect onto it. So if I just click and drag an echo effect there, you can see we're getting these echoes, and then I'm just gonna change our echo operator to composite in front. Turn up the number of echoes. Let's turn it up to like 5 echoes. I'll take the decay down a little bit. Let's take it to like, let's go to like 0.7 there. So we kind of get this blur happening with the echoes as well. Let's check out what this looks like. Back in this bitch, we lit. This last transition is actually more of a background rotate transition. So this is going to be really cool. We're going to have it take place on these next couple of clips here. So there's like 2 kick drum hits right here. First one, I'm back on my shit, yeah. So let's just start it at this very first kick drum right here. Let's drag this first clip up and then let's drag out our next clip underneath. Right click on our top clip. We're going to hit Nest. We're going to right click on it again, replace with After Effects Composition, duplicate our layer. We're going to rename this one on the bottom background, and then we'll name this one on the top rotoscope. So with my roto layer selected, I'm going to do a quick rotoscope. Now that I've got him rotoscoped out, I'll come back to my composition here and turn off the background layer to make sure that we got him nice and clean on the screen. So back in my composition, if I just hide the background layer, we should see him appear on this transparent background. Now with my background layer turned back on, what I'm actually going to do for this is move our anchor point. So our anchor point is basically a reference to After Effects where we want the motion to be centered around. So what we can do with this anchor point, since it's right here in the middle of our clip, is come up here to our anchor point tool, click it once, and just move our anchor point. Let's move it up to this top left corner. So I'm actually going to click back on my selection tool right here. I'm going to come down to my background layer and I'm going to hit R to pull up our rotation. And now when I rotate it, you can see the background rotates around that center point. Say I undo where we just moved our center point to and keep it here in the middle and try to do this rotation effect. You see how the background is now going to rotate around the center right there. So that's why I move it up to the top left. So I'm just gonna do that again really quickly here. I'm gonna move our anchor point up here to the top left, and then I'm gonna make a keyframe here on the rotation value 0, and then I'm going to have it rotate out of the frame. And I'm gonna move that keyframe that we just created to the very end so it falls out gradually right there. Right click on this first keyframe and hit easy ease out. And I'm gonna change the value of that via the graph editor. I'm gonna turn my motion blur back on. Let's move this second keyframe in about halfway like so. And now at this point where the background is pretty much transitioned out of the screen, what we can do with our cutout, our rotoscope layer, is the same thing. We can take our anchor point and let's move the anchor point somewhere right in the middle of his body, and then we're going to click back on our selection tool. Let's have him kind of jump up and fall out of the frames. Hit P to pull up my position keyframe. I'm going to make a position right there, and then we're going to have him kind of go up a little bit right here, and then we can have him fall out of the picture just like that. So he kind of jumps up, boom, and then jumps back down. And then what I'm also going to do is keyframe the scale so it gets a little bit smaller. So let's start the scale right here. And again, we're going to easy ease out that scale. And then let's scroll over here to where this transition starts to kind of finish up. And let's shrink him down. Let's go to like 50% or so. And now we should see him kind of jump up, get a little smaller, and then fall out of the screen just like so. So let's hop back into Premiere Pro and just preview all of these transitions back to back to back.
Back in this bitch. Back in this bitch we lit. Yeah, what's out the city to fall? First one, I'm back on my shit. Yeah. All of you niggas be hating on the niggas, suck on the dick.
I hope you guys found this video valuable. If you're interested in adding some sauce to your visuals today, definitely check out my website, venturevisuals.com. I have a free pack on there where you can test all the products on my website completely free of charge. I even have some matte transitions included in the pack so you can get a very similar look to what we did today in this tutorial. If that sounds interesting to you, definitely check the links in the description below. If you made it to this point in the video, I really appreciate you. If you have any questions, comments, or concerns, please let me know. You can reach out to me directly on Instagram or just comment on this video. I respond to pretty much everyone who comments and messages me. And if you have any dope ideas for upcoming tutorials I should do, definitely let me know down below. And until next time, I'm Jake Venner. Peace out.